In this video, you will learn how to build an image classification application in KNIME Analytics platform. We will demonstrate the image classification with an example of recognizing cats and dogs. To do so, we collect a bunch of labeled images and use them to train a neural network. The trained network will later be able to automatically identify the two classes for new images. The model is a convolutional neural network, which is one of the most adopted architectures to deal with image data. Let's open KNIME Analytics platform and have a look at the workflow to define and train the model. The training data consists of images and their associated labels, cat or dog. Here, we read the images into the workflow and perform the pre-processing steps to normalize their value and adjust them to a common size. Let's next have a look at the network architecture. As you already know, each node represents a layer of the network. We begin with the Keras input layer node. Our images have a size of 150 x 150 pixels, with 3 color channels. Therefore, open the configuration dialog of the Keras input layer node and set these values in the shape field. Make sure to select the right data format. In this case, we put 3, the number of channels, as last. Then, the Keras convolution 2D layer node creates the first convolutional layer. In the node's configuration dialog, you can set many important parameters, such as the number of filters, the kernel size, the stride, the padding method, and the activation function for this layer. Next, a Keras max pooling 2D layer scales down the data size. Using a 2x2 pool size and a 2x2 stride, this layer reduces the size of the first two data dimensions by a factor of 2. Notice that you can check the size of the data evolving through the network by hovering on the Keras network output port. After repeating another convolutional and max pooling layer, the network is enhanced with a Keras flatten layer node. This layer reduces the shape of the output to a single dimension. We conclude with two Keras dense layer nodes, which correspond to the classic fully connected layers of a neural network. Amongst them, you can see the Keras dropout layer node. We set a dropout rate of 0.5, meaning that half of this layer's input is set to 0. This should prevent model overfitting. Notice that the last dense layer has a single output with a sigmoid activation function. This means that the model's final output is a number between 0 and 1. This perfectly fits the binary classification task. That is to say, you can associate the two classes of dogs and cats to 0 and 1 respectively, and interpret the model's output according to how close it is to each of those values. The execution of the deep learning nodes in KNIME requires a Conda environment containing the necessary packages. However, what if you want to execute this workflow on a new machine that does not have the packages installed? Do you have to set it up manually? Luckily, no. You can make use of the Conda Environment Propagation node. This node lets you select one of the Conda environments available on your machine and collects its package list. Upon execution, this node detects if the selected environment is available in the machine, and if not, installs it. This way, we can easily export our environment for a smooth execution on a new machine. Now, you're finally ready to train the network using the Keras Network Learner node. Let's have a look at its configuration window. In the Input Data tab, select the table column you want to use as training data. The dialog box also gives you information about the network input shape, namely the size defined in the Keras input layer node during the architecture definition. Therefore, the training data that you select below must match this size. Selecting the conversion technique from Image in the menu, the node will automatically transform the image column into a format accepted by the network. You can see similar options in the Target Data tab. There is the shape of the model output, the table columns to be used as target data, and the conversion method. As a loss function, we select the binary cross entropy, since we are solving a binary classification problem. Finally, in the executable selection tab, you can specify within which environment you want to execute this node. The environment exported by the Conda Environment Propagation node can be selected by setting the respective flow variable. After the training is complete, you can finally apply the model to the test data with the Keras Executor node and check how well it performed with the Scorer node. In the Keras Network Executor node, specify which table columns are passed to the model and the relative conversion strategy. In the bottom, you can select one or more desired output layers. This way, you could also check the value of any hidden network layer. In most cases, however, you are just interested in the final output of the model. Therefore, select the output sigmoid layer. The output of the model is, as expected, a decimal number between 0 and 1. Let's convert this prediction to a class, creating a simple rule with a rule engine node. If the output value is above 0.5, it is a cat. If it is below, it's a dog. Finally, to manually inspect the labeled images of the testset, we built a dashboard. With it, we can check the model prediction cat by cat and dog by dog to find out which particular images were predicted correctly and incorrectly. In this video, you have learned how to define the architecture of a convolutional neural network and how to train and apply a CNN model for image classification. If you want to reproduce this example, don't forget to install the required extensions attached to this video.